Hey guys, Enzo Warren is with us today. He is a professional carver and entrepreneur. He's got a website, enzoswoodshop.com.
Exactly, yeah.
Check out his stuff over there. Well, he's been using LT Wright knives for a while in his carvings, and today we brought him down to the shop, and he's doing some really cool stuff for us, and we want to get his thoughts on the Kerf carver that we're building for Woodsman. So Enzo, when you look for a carver, let's just start there. Like, overall knife, when you're looking for a carver for your personal uses, what do you look for?
Typically what I look for is a knife that's going to be sturdy. I don't like flexible carvers. And I also look for a knife that's going to be comfortable. And comfortable not just in the hand comfort sense, which is important, but also comfortable to actually get whittling done with. So it's got to be versatile. It's got to be able to do the various cuts that need to get done for various projects. And so I look for typically something with a bit of belly, some straight edge, a tip that's easily controlled, and a handle that I can whittle with for as many hours as I do without getting any hot spots or hand cramps or anything like that.
Interesting. When you speak of the handle, the Kerf carver, that has a unique handle.
It does.
It's our coffin shape or hammer handle, if you would call it. It does have some edges, but I don't think they are pronounced. They just fit comfortably into the hand. What's your takes on the actual handle of that knife?
So I've been whittling with it for several hours today so far, and what I've found is that the handle is surprisingly nice. When I looked at it online, I noticed the edges, and I was thinking to myself, how's that gonna feel in hand? What I found is that it's really nice. Basically, this flat, all the flats on it, I found to offer really good control. So when I put my thumb on the back and I push, it's kind of like all the force is in a specific, precise direction. It's really easy to get fine control done. And so later I'll show you guys some really fine carving I did with it. And it's easy because it's easy to control. And either grip, whether I'm with my thumb on the back, pinch grip, either way, it just controls nicely. I spend a lot of time with the knife in this position, my hand, with this part right seated in my palm. And with that curve, it just sits. It's comfortable. And so whether I'm doing chest pulls and putting a lot of pressure on the handle, because that's something where if a knife has hot spots at the bottom of the handle, instantly I can tell. Especially when I do an hour, 2 hours of using it that way, my hand will feel it. This, it just sits and it's just comfortable. And so whether I'm doing chest pulls with a lot of pressure or kind of these more fine controlled push cuts like this handle just sits so nicely. So that's what I found.
Yeah, I also think that the flat spots, as you spoke earlier, they help you with your indexing.
They do.
I hadn't really
absolutely
given a lot of thought about that flat spot on the back, keeping you controlled, not allowing your thumb to slip to the, let's say, a more rounded,
sure,
what we would think is a more comfortable handle. But this knife is, as you said, very comfortable in that handle position.
Absolutely. Typically, though, what I like is having a decent amount of meat, like this, basically, on sort of the base of the blade, so that when I'm doing kind of more rigorous material removal, where I'm doing chest pulls or whatever, it just works nicely. But I also like having a fine tip, so that when there are nooks and crannies that I'm whittling, or fine details that have a lot of turns in them, where I'm turning the knife on the piece, the fine tip allows the knife to actually turn instead of get stuck or block itself from being able to make that cut. And so with a fine tip like this and on some other knives, I've found that it's nice having both, basically. I like having a knife that has both. And what I also like is in a blade to have a good amount of belly, because when I'm carving the flat of a spatula or of a larger spoon handle or something, this this curved section allows me to kind of form a plane on the piece of wood much easier than it would be to use just a straight no curve edge. And so I do like having a curved edge on my knife, absolutely.
Very cool. And so for a guy who's starting out, let's say, trying to get his feet wet, interested in carving, maybe wants to do some spoons, some trinkets, is this a good starting point, that knife?
100%.
Yeah. 100%. That would be in your recommended pile of knives?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. I'd say this knife would be great for anybody. Just picking it up, or somebody who's, you know, a master at it and has been doing it for 20 years, I think anybody would like it.
So. Well, thank you very much for your input. We'd love to see a few of the things that you were able to carve, if you have them with you.
Sure.
So these are things you've done today with that knife.
I have.
And again, full disclosure, this is the first day you've handled that knife, right?
It is, yes. This morning was the first time I've ever touched it.
It's not like you have months and months under that blade.
No, I don't. Yeah, no. So I'm still working on several projects here. I've got a couple spreader blanks that I'm going to be doing up nicely with this knife. Working on a tri-stick, Morskonski tri-stick. But I've also done 5 of these little heads. Now,
those are an Easter Island style head.
Basically, yeah.
Another name for it.
Like Moais.
Okay.
Easter Island heads. Head statues, whatever you want to call them. They are little faces. They all sit flat, and I found them to be excellent ways to get acquainted with a knife and to develop finer whittling skills, because they've got a lot of different cuts involved, including that planing cut where you're kind of leveraging that knife with the curved section of the blade. It allows you to get these surfaces really flat. All of these heads stand perfectly on a flat surface.
I hadn't thought about that. That's a good tip.
And then another thing that they do is they're kind of proof of how well a knife controls, the edge controls. Because with a face, a humanoid face, it becomes really apparent when the eyes are uneven or when the nose is a little wonky. And so when you can get faces that are very symmetrical, you're able to really kind of get a feel for how finely that edge controls and how comfortable it is to control the edge. And with these, I mean, it was perfect. First time ever picking up the knife and there was no problems. It was great.
That sounds great. Thank you very much for coming down today and working with a knife, giving us some feedback, actually making some product. At least go check out Enzo's stuff at enzosworkshop.com. Man, he's got some cool stuff going on. Again, just starting out in the web arena out there, getting his stuff up and running. But always like to support good people. Guys, thank you very much. Enzo, thank you very much for coming down today.
And thank you for having me.
Giving us some feedback on that knife.